My primary theory is that the way things function in a tease's storyline and in their content as a whole relies on pairs of opposites. It doesn't matter what those opposites are, up and down, hot and cold, day and night, awake and asleep, etc. The only requirement is that they must be equals as well as opposites. So, for example, winter and summer. Winter and summer are equals, they're both seasons, but they're also opposites. They occur at opposite points in time during the year. And this idea is represented by the shape of the chromer. The two halves of the chromer are equals, but they face in opposite directions. And there's this super special point where they come together, this point where two opposites intermix, transition, or overlap. And since X marks the spot, what exists at that point is treasure. So let's say our pair of opposites are A and Z, and at the midpoint between opposites, we have treasure. T. A. T. Z. A. T's. A. T's. A. T's name is basically like the way you pronounce this shape. In the lyrics of Say My Name, they say that their name is A to the Z, which is quite fun since to and the are also both words that start with T. Additionally, this shape is a figure eight. So you can also think of it like their name is Eight E's, hinting to the fact that there are eight members. The letters A and Z are the letters at the beginning and the end of the alphabet, and they're placed at the beginning and the end of Atiza's name. So within their name, we get this coupling of the beginning and the end. In their storyline, ATs travel between Old World, or World A, and New World, or World Z. So ATs are the bridge between A and Z. The more official explanation we've been given about ATs' name is that it's meant to mean A, teenager, Z. Now, in a lot of ATs content, they explore this ideological war between children and adults. But in my opinion, being a child and being an adult in the realm of AT's theoriness doesn't really have a lot to do with your age. Like, the year somebody is born is not necessarily the determining factor on if they're considered a child or an adult. The definition I would give for children and adults in AT's content is that a child is someone who believes in their dreams, and an adult is someone who believes in reality. You can see this especially in the many stories ATs has referenced in which children fall asleep and travel to a new world in their dreams. This is the plot of Peter Pan, Alice in Wonderland, Jumanji, The Wizard of Oz, etc. And in most of these stories, there's a moment at the end where adults, usually the parents, come home, wake the kids up, and proceed to make fun of them for believing in their dreams. I'll use Peter Pan as an example. The Darling children believe Neverland is real. They believe all of these adventures actually happened to them. The Darling parents, on the other hand, think this is ridiculous, childish. They believe that London is the real world. And this difference in perspective is not only true of the characters in the story, but of the audience as well. If you're a little kid and you watch Peter Pan, you believe Neverland is real. Whereas if you watch Peter Pan as an adult, it's super obvious to you that these kids fall asleep and Neverland is just a dream. I also think it's interesting that a lot of these stories are specifically bedtime stories. So, like, the story itself is this transition between being awake and being asleep, this transition between the world of reality and the world of your dreams. Children and adults are opposites. They are at opposite stages of life, opposite points in time. So then, what happens here? Well, if you're a child, you grow up and become an adult. Growing up is when you start to do things your own way. It's also the point where someone may experience confusion, where people start to question the world around them and their own identity. But how does someone transition from being an adult to being a child? Well, I think the answer is in the lyrics of Fever. If you're an adult and you live younger, you become a child. A child is someone who was recently born. You might even say that they are new to this world. An adult is someone who has been alive for longer. they're old. For a child, their future is adulthood. For an adult, their past is childhood. Conversations between children and adults in a tease content can also be interpreted as conversations between someone from the past and someone from the future, or as conversations between someone from Old World and someone from New World. When ATEEZ debuted, they were rookies, the children of the music industry. By the end of their careers, they will be well-established, the leaders, the adults of the industry. ATEEZ's long journey is the journey in which they grow up. The adults who ridicule ATEEZ, saying that their clothes are all wrong, that their music doesn't belong here, are the pre-existing adults of the music industry, the established authority figures ATEEZ are attempting to usurp. It's also reflective of the polite adult society that looks down on adventurous and rebellious youth culture. The resistance fight to overthrow the Strickland government is just a metaphor for ATEEZ's place in the K-pop industry and their lived experience of growing up, in which they enter this strange new world, gain loyal followers, and disrupt the establishment. So right here at the transition point between being a child and being an adult is growing up and living younger, or alternatively, being a teenager. If a child is someone who believes in their dreams and an adult is someone who believes in reality, then a teenager is someone who believes in making their dreams a reality. They believe in themselves. ATEEZ proposes that we can all be teenagers. All children have the capacity to grow up, and all adults have the capacity to live younger. Anyone in the world can make their dreams a reality. And this just might be especially true when your name is ATEEZ.